What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Monty, and in today's video, I'm bringing you guys my 2019 to 2020 NFL playoff predictions video. But before I get started, I just wanted to thank you guys real quick for 1,000 subscribers, man. It's been a goal I had for a long time, and we finally hit it today. But I just wanted to say thank you guys. We're going to keep grinding, and 2020 is my year. All right, so we're going to start off with the left side of the AFC. First game we're going to talk about is the Texans and the Bills. So a couple key things I want to point out in this matchup. The Bills defense has been strong all year. One of the best in the league, one of the best in the league. Texans defense been good. Just got J.J. Watt back. That's going to be a big help for this game. And I mean big help. That's going to be he's going to be an X factor for this next game coming up. The Texans offense with Deshaun Watson, they've been rolling all season. They've lost a couple big games here and there. Bills offense has been, I wouldn't say struggled, but they definitely haven't struggled, but they found a way to score. And that's really the key thing with the Bills offense. But in terms of wide receivers and scoring options, they don't really have many. Frank Gore, the veteran, he's been in the league for like 14 years. Then they got Devin Singletary, the rookie. So it's difficult. It's a difficult spot to be in with the running back position. Josh Allen has been a breakout QB for them. But really, the only wide receiver they have is Sean Brown. And I think that's going to be the difference of this game. I think they're not going to be able to find a way to score against this Texans defense. I think the Texans is going to find more ways to score. And I think the Texans are going to take this one home. And I'm pretty sure about that. So place your bets on the Texans. Okay, for the next matchup in the AFC, the Patriots and the Titans. This one's kind of a no-brainer. Patriots definitely could have had the 2 seed, but they lost to the Dolphins last week. And the Chiefs, I believe, beat the Chargers. So that gave the Chiefs a 2 seed, the Patriots a 3 seed. Patriots are at Gillette Stadium in Foxborough. The home field advantage is really going to kill the Titans, I think. Not too many Titans fans are going to be showing up to that game, but it's not going to be a blowout like everybody expects. The Titans are they're a real team. You know, they definitely deserve the playoff spot, but it's kind of a no-brainer here. The Patriots probably should have had the bye. I think they're going to have an easy game here. Bill Belichick, Tom Brady, maybe it's last year, maybe next year. I don't know. He says he doesn't want to retire, apparently, but we're going to have to see. I think Patriots are going to win this one by at least a 2-score game, maybe 14 or 17. Kind of a no-brainer here. Okay, we're moving on to the NFC now. First game we're going to talk about is the Eagles and the Seahawks. Seahawks obviously have the edge over him here, even though being away for this game. The Eagles and the Cowboys, man, what a both terrible seasons for them. I believe they finished 9-7. Cowboys finished, I think, 9-7, but that game in week 16, Eagles versus Cowboys, Eagles won it. That gave them the playoff spot. I don't know. I would have to say, even though with the home field advantage, Seahawks are still going to bring it to them with Marshawn Lynch. They just have more options to score with on offense. The receiving game for the Eagles is just so bad. This one, I don't want to say no-brainer. It's going to be like a 7 or 10-point game. It may go down to the end. But don't sleep on the Eagles, but I definitely have the Seahawks here. All right, for the last game in the NFC and in the first round is the Vikings and the Saints. This is going to be a good game, but Saints obviously having a lot of weapons on offense. Drew Brees, Michael Thomas, Alvin Kamara, Jared Cook has been a breakout in this last half of the season. Defense has been playing a lot better than they were in the first half of the season. Vikings obviously having a couple things not going in their favor throughout the year, including Kirk Cousins really not showing up during prime time and in the big moments, which you really need out of a quarterback. And I really just think because of that simple reason, even though, you know, Dalvin Cook, I don't even know if Dalvin Cook's playing. I think he is, but I don't think it's going to be enough to beat the Saints. They're going to be a good playoff contender. And I got the Saints over the Vikings here. Okay, into the second round here. Once again, we're going to start on the top left with the AFC again. Texans versus Ravens. Ravens, number one seed, obviously having that week in advance to prepare for the game. This is going to be a battle. Lamar Jackson versus Sean Watson. We've seen it in college before. Both clutch quarterbacks. Both very fast, very mobile. This is going to be a really good game. I think it's going to come down to whoever shows up more on the defensive side of things. If the Ravens D shows up, I think they're gonna have the edge on them. If the Texans D shows up, they could possibly have the slight edge. The thing is, the Ravens run game is so good. You cannot stop them, even with JJ Watt. I mean, they could have Clowney back. I don't even think they could stop the run game with Mark Ingram and Lamar Jackson. You really need fast outside linebackers to really contain this quarterback. I just don't think it's going to happen. I think the Ravens are going to have the slight edge over them. And honestly, I think it's going to be a very close game, maybe 3-point differential or 7-point differential. But I think Ravens over Texans. Okay, so next game in the AFC, we get the Chiefs versus the Patriots. This is going to be a rematch of last year's conference game, conference matchup. This is going to be probably one of the best games in the playoffs this year. Very, very, very similar teams. Actually, I shouldn't say similar teams, but very. Their head coaches are both. They both want to win. The head coaches are two of the best in the league. They're veterans. They know what they're doing. And they both just have great teams on paper, great quarterbacks. I'd probably say Patrick Mahomes is a little better than Brady because obviously he has the age differential over Brady. But the Chiefs, I think the Chiefs going on the road here are going to beat the Patriots simply because of the fact that the Patriots are gonna, they played the week before, the Chiefs didn't, they're rested, Patriots aren't. You know, they got to go. They're staying at home. Yes, they're not flying back and forth. But I really, really do believe, just for some reason, I can't pinpoint it. I'm telling you, the Chiefs are going to win this game. Tyreek Hill, they're just starting to figure out this run game, too. Their run game has been terrible all year. It's just been starting to figure out their run game on both sides of the ball. I mean, on the offense and the defense. I think they're going to be able to contain the Patriots. I'm going to go Chiefs over Pats here. Okay, on to the NFC. Niners versus Seahawks. We just saw this game last week. Came down to a game of inches. Great game. One of the best games of the year. But this game is not going to be a game of inches. It's not going to be the same result. Seahawks are coming into the Niners territory. First playoff game the Niners will play it in a couple, will have played in a couple years. And the Seahawks are going to come in and beat them. Mark my words, if this game happens, the Seahawks will come in there and they will beat them. I'm going to tell you why. Russell Wilson was playing like an MVP, kind of fell off a little, but we could still throw him in the MVP conversation. Jimmy Garoppolo is going to hurt the 49ers so badly. He's just not going to perform in the clutch. Their run game is good, but the Seahawks run, their run defense is just going to, I think they're going to shut him down on all ends of everything. I really think it's going to be a defensive game, but I think it's going to end like a 20-14 type game. You know, it's going to come down to the last drive. Obviously, they're not going to come into the Niners territory and kill them, but it's going to be like a 20-14 game, one possession game. I'm going Seahawks on this one, 100%. Okay, so the last matchup of the NFC, the Packers versus the Saints. Saints going into Lambeau Field, night game. It's going to be cold. That there's already one factor for the Packers over the Saints. I'm just going to say to you right now, everybody says, you know, Saints this, Saints that, Saints going to the Super Bowls. Saints been so lucky, unlucky the past couple of years. I think the Packers are just going to come into this game. They're just going to go into it very, very strongly, off to a great start, and just not let go of that lead. Because that's really what they need to do against the Saints. being, you know, the Saints having the team that they have, so good on both sides of the ball. But I think the Packers are going to have more time to prep for this game. They're going to be more confident coming in. Aaron Jones is going to have a breakout game. Devontae Adams, too. I think the second receiver for the Packers, they've been struggling all year. Geronimo Allison and Marquise Valdes-Scantling both have not been doing much. I think one of them are going to break out, maybe 100 yards and a touchdown. And also, Alan Lazard will step up the line. I feel like everything is just going to go the Packers' way. Saints, they're going to have a lot go their way, too, because it's going to be hard to stop them. I can guarantee you that. But I'm pretty confident the Packers are going to have the edge over this. This is a shocking one to a lot of people, but I'm honestly, I've been looking at a couple factors. I really do think the Packers will have the edge over the Saints here. And the main one I'm going to tell you right now is that home field advantage. Saints are so comfortable playing in the Superdome. They're going to come into Green Bay and not know what to do. It's going to be a close game. I think it's going to be a little more high scoring, maybe like a 35 to 31 game, something like that. Packers over the Saints. Okay, we are into the conference championship rounds. Starting off with the AFC, Ravens versus Chiefs. This is to go to the Super Bowl. I've talked about the Ravens before. I've talked about the Chiefs before. I said the Texans were going to play play the Ravens very, very hard. And I think the Chiefs will do the same as well. I think the Chiefs are going to come in there with a better game plan than the Ravens. They're going to figure out how to shut down Lamar after the last game, watching the Texans game. And I feel like they had the whole year to prepare for this game. This is the Chiefs came to win. The Ravens not really struggled with the passing game all year, but they haven't been so successful with it. The run game is really where they have been succeeding throughout this year. And the Chiefs, like I said in the last game, the Chiefs and the Patriots game, they've been figuring out their offense more and more as the week's been going. You saw in the Chargers game, they were just completely took control of that game. And honestly, even on the road here, I got the Chiefs. I have the Chiefs over the Ravens. And really, a lot of people don't expect the Chiefs to be in the Super Bowl. But I don't know. I've saw something out of this team this year with Andy Reid, Patrick Mahomes. Their defense is getting better each and every game. I really do think all the Ravens do have is the run game with Lamar Jackson and Mark Ingram. Chiefs over Ravens. Chiefs are in the Super Bowl. Okay, final game before the Super Bowl. Packers versus Seahawks, big one. Packers with the home field advantage at Lambeau against the Seahawks. Seahawks, Marshawn Lynch, Russell Wilson, Tyler Lockett. Very good all-around offense. Packers, Aaron Jones, Aaron Rodgers, Devontae Adams. Defenses. Seahawks have the edge over the Packers here. But the Packers pass rushers, Preston Smith, Za'Darius Smith, haven't talked about them yet. The lockdown corner, Jair Alexander out of Louisville. I believe the Packers, their defense is really going to step up in this game. They have to shut down Russell Wilson in this stuff. The offense of the Seahawks have been hard to stop all year long. We've known it. Russell Wilson was an MVP candidate for the first half of the season. Then he kind of slowed down. But the Packers are going to contain them. Now, the Packers offense has struggled finding that number two receiver, like I said earlier. The running game, they have found their running back. And I'm going to give you two main reasons why the Packers win this game. Home field advantage. Seahawks are coming to Lambeau Field to play them. And Aaron Rodgers. Aaron Rodgers is the clutchest quarterback of all time, and he will be more clutch than ever in this game. Packers over Seahawks. Okay, we made it to the last game, the Super Bowl. I got the Chiefs facing off against the Packers in Miami. This is going to be a game for the ages, the rematch of Super Bowl I. Patrick Mahomes versus Aaron Rodgers. Tyreek Hill versus Devontae Adams. Jair Alexander, Preston Smith, Za'Darius Smith, Chris Jones, Tyrann Mathieu, all these key players are going to play a part in this game. It's going to be a very interesting game to watch. And I do strongly believe this game will happen. And I don't know, man. These two teams are both really nobody thinks they're going to be in the Super Bowl. Let's just put that out there right now. Nobody thinks they're going to be in the Super Bowl. Their defenses are both not the best. They both struggled on some parts of the offense all year long. But it's really going to come down to who was more prepared. And I'm going to be real with you. The Packers will be more prepared. The rookie head coach, Matt LaFleur, will come to Miami. He will take down Andy Reid, Patrick Mahomes. And another thing, I'm going to give you two main reasons why the Packers are going to win this game. Like I said earlier, Aaron Rodgers, clutchest quarterback of all time. Aaron Jones, he's going to be in the mix the whole entire playoff run, and he will not stop this game. And the last reason, the play calling and the defense will step up big. They will overtake this Chiefs offense with Tyreek Hill, Sammy Watkins, Patrick Mahomes, Travis Kelce. They will overtake them, and they will be your 2019 to 2020 Super Bowl champs. Thank you guys for watching. I'm pretty confident about these predictions. We'll come back and we'll check on them within the next 2 months when the Super Bowl happens. But thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys have a good day. And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.